Hello friends and welcome to this video. In this video I am going to show you how to use the calculator to find the interpolating values using Lagrange's interpolation method. Lagrange's interpolation method is generally used to find the interpolating values when the values of x are unequally spaced. So let's consider the numerical. We are given the different tabulated values of x and y, and we have to find the value of y at x is equal to 1.5. So first of all, we are going to write the given data. The n is equal to 4. So here n is nothing but the number of data points. So these data points given as a 4. So we have written n is equal to 4. And xg value is nothing but the value of x at which we have to find the value of y. So xg is given as 1.5. Now for these tabulated values, we are writing the notation for first value of x as a x0, then x1, x2 and x3. And for y values, we are writing the notation as y0, y1, y2 and y3. And using these notations, we can find the values of yg at a given value of xg. So the formula is written as, for 4 number of data points, yg is equal to l0, y0 plus l1, y1 plus l2, y2 plus l3, y3. This formula is written for n minus 1 terms. So as we are having the n as a 4, that is number of data points, so it is written as n minus 3, that is up to the third term. So that's why we have written it up to the L3 and Y3. So this L0, L1, L2 and L3 are nothing but the Lagrange's terms. These Lagrange's terms can be find out again using the formula xg minus x1 in second bracket xg minus x2 in third bracket xg minus x3 divided by x0 minus x1 in second bracket x0 minus x2 in third bracket x0 minus x3. So this can be calculated to get the value of L0. So these terms again written for n minus 1 terms. So as we are having n is equal to 4, so we have written here 3 terms, then multiplied by y0. This L1 term can be calculated by using this formula, then multiplied by y1. Again, using this, we can calculate the L2 value, then multiplied by y2. And using this formula, we can able to calculate the L3 value, and again multiplied by y3, then we'll be get the yg value. So when we put the different values of xg, x1, x2, then we'll be get the first term L0, y0 as minus 0.175, L1, y1 as 1.9687, L2, y2 value is 5.25, and L3, y3 value is minus 0.9187. After calculating, we'll get the value of yg as a 6.125. So we can finally write the value of yg is equal to 6.125 at xg is equal to 1.5. So in this way, you can able to calculate the value of yg. Now I am going to show you how to use the calculator effectively to get these values within few seconds. So for calculator, we are going to write the formula as y is equal to in bracket xg minus a, in second bracket xg minus b, in third bracket xg minus c. Here there are 3 terms, so we have to write up to the 3 terms. If there are more than 3 terms, then you can able to write again xg minus d, xg minus e and so on, because it will depend upon the number of data points. As we are having n is equal to 4, so we need to write the 3 terms, that is n minus 1. Then it is divided by x minus a, x minus b and x minus c, and then multiplied by y. So these terms we have to write. For L0, Y0, we have to write the xg value. A will be denoted as x1, b will be denoted as x2 and c will be denoted as x3. Then again, the x0 is common for all the terms, so it will be denoted as x. Again, x1, x2 and x3 will be denoted as a, b and c. And this y will be denoted as a y0. Then for L1 term, again this x0, x2 and x3 will be denoted as a, b and c. And again, x1 is a common term, so it will be denoted as a x, and then again multiplied by y. So y1 will be denoted again y. So in this way you have to write. And how to define this in calculator I am going to show you. Then After we have to give the colon, then it is written as f is equal to f plus y. Here f is just as a variable and it is written as f plus y because there is a sequential addition of these terms. So that's why here again same variable is written and then we are adding the y terms. So let's open the calculator and I am going to show you how to define this value and how to get the final value of yg. Now in calculator we have to define this formula as it is. So first of all we have to write y is equal to, so press alpha y, then again alpha and equal to, then we have to use in bracket this xg minus a, xg minus b, xg minus c. So in bracket the xg is nothing but the constant terms that is given as a 1.5. so we have to write this value as it is, 1.5 minus a. So write alpha a, bracket complete. Then in second bracket xg minus b, so xg value is again 1.5 minus b, so press alpha and b, bracket complete. And again in third bracket 1.5 minus c, so again press alpha and c, then bracket complete. Now go to the downward position by using this downward arrow key. Now we have to write x minus a, x minus b and x minus c. So it is written as it is. So in bracket
alpha x minus alpha a, bracket complete. In second bracket alpha x minus alpha b, bracket complete. And in third bracket alpha x minus alpha c, bracket complete.
So in this way these terms are defined. Then go to the right hand side by this rightward arrow key, then it will be multiplied by y. So press again alpha and y, then give this colon, so press again alpha colon, then f, so press f, so again alpha f equal to, so alpha equal to f plus y. So again press alpha f plus alpha y. So in this way these terms is defined in the calculator. Now to get the values you have to press this calc c button. So it is ask you to the a value. So here a value for the first term is nothing but x1 value. So x1 value is 1, so press 1 equal to. B value is nothing but x2 value, which is given as a 2, so press 2 equal to. Then c value is nothing but x3 value, so x3 value is given as a 5, so press 5 equal to. Then it asks you the x value. So for this first term x value is nothing but our x0 value, which is given as a 0, so press 0 equal to. And then it asks you the y value. So y value is nothing but for first term is y0, which is given as a 2, so press 2 equal to. Then it asks you the f value. For each and every problem initially you have to take the value of f as a 0 because there is a simultaneous addition. So we are initialize the f value as a 0 because there is no change in the answer when you add it by 0. So press 0 equal to. Then you will be get the value of y. This value is nothing but L0 y0 value. So when you press this button we will be get the value as a minus 0.175. So this is the same value. Then again press equal to. So f value will be get, which is again same value because we are having f as a 0 and y value as a 0.175. so 0 minus 0.175, the value is again same. Then again press equal to. Again it asks you the new value of a. So now we have to input the a, b, c values for this second term. So a value is x0, which is given as a 0, so press 0 equal to. B value is x2, which is given as a 2, so press 2 equal to. And c value is x3 value, which is given as a 5, so press 5 equal to. Then x value is nothing but the x1 value. So x1 value is given as a 1, so press 1 equal to. Then it asks you the y value. So for this second term y value is nothing but y1, so y1 value is given as a 3, so press 3 equal to. And then no need to enter the f value, you can directly press the equal to sign. So we'll be get the value of y. This value is nothing but L1 y1 value. So when you press this key you will be get the L1Y1 value as a 1.9687. So this value is written here. Then again press equal to sign, you will be get the value of F. So this value is nothing but the addition of these two terms. So when you add these two terms, the answer you will be get as a this. Okay, so press equal to sign, then it again asks you the new A value. So the new A value we have to write for this third term. So A value is x0, which is given as a 0. So press 0 equal to B value is x1 value, which is given as 1. So press 1 equal to C value is x3 value, which is given as a 5. So press 5 equal to, then it asks you the x value. So for this third term, x value is nothing but x2, which is given as 2. So press 2 equal to, and y value is nothing but y2 value, so which is 12. So press 12 equal to, then no need to again enter the F value, directly click on equal to sign. So you will be get the value of L2 Y2. So this value is 5.25. So same value we have written here. Then again press equal to sign, again you will be get the F plus Y value. So that is the answer is nothing but these three terms addition. So directly press equal to sign, it asks you the new value of A. So we have to write the ABC value for this fourth term. So A value is nothing but x0, which is given as a 0. Press 0 equal to B value is x1, which is given as a 1. So press 1 equal to, and C value is nothing but x2 value, which is given as a 2. So press 2 and equal to. Then it asks you the x value. So for this third term, x value is nothing but x3 value, which is given as a 5. So press 5 equal to, and then it asks you the y value. So y value is nothing but y3 value, which is given as 147. So press 147, then equal to, then again no need to enter the f value, directly click on equal to sign. So you will be get this y value as a L3 Y3 value, which is as minus 0.91875. so this is the same value. Then again press the equal to sign, we will get the final value of YG, that is the addition of all these four terms. So this value is nothing but 6.125. so this is the final value of Y will be get, and it is written here. So in this way you can able to calculate the value of YG at a given value of X using this calculator very easily within the few seconds. So I hope you enjoy this video, and you will be able to find the value of Y at any value of X for the given tabulated value using the calculator very easily. If you have any queries or questions, you can post in the comment. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.